Hello, I am Dr. Rita Modi, fertility consultant at Currae Hospital. People ask us about how exactly IVF works step by step. It's a long procedure. So I would just explain how exactly it works. So the first step is to identify which couple is going to require IVF, to investigate and prepare them for their IVF procedure. So once they are prepared, we have to stimulate the lady's ovaries to produce multiple follicles. By which I mean that they receive hormonal injections in a calculated manner, in a highly monitored protocol. The idea is to try and develop multiple follicles. Naturally, the lady is going to produce only one egg in one cycle. So optimizing the results of IVF would require that we get multiple eggs from the lady's body. So this requires hormone injections, which typically starts from first or second day of periods. And they continue for roughly about 10-12 days. This is one of the most commonly used protocols. Of course, there are other protocols, other ways of stimulating the ovaries. Now, it would require monitoring by repeated blood tests and sonographic examinations to see how the follicles are growing. Once the follicles are grown, the eggs have to be harvested from the woman's body. This would require a surgical procedure, which is essentially a needle aspiration thing. It happens in the OT. Under strict aseptic conditions and may require either deep sedation or general anesthesia, which is generally a short general anesthesia. Through the vaginal route, we send a needle under sonographic guidance to aspirate out the contents of the follicles, and then we actually see it under microscope to see the eggs, to see the actual number and the quality of the eggs. So we separate the best quality eggs from whatever we have got from the lady's body. We keep the lady under observation for a few hours, and once she is ready to go home, we discharge her in about 2 to 3 hours. So essentially it is a day care procedure. The same day we also take husband's semen sample and we separate good quality sperm from it. Then each individual sperm is selected and placed inside one good quality, each individual good quality egg. This is going to give us fertilization. So at a certain calculated hours from the time of inserting the sperm into the egg, we check for fertilization, and once the fertilization happens, we provide the developing embryo with the correct environment and the nutrients that it would require for growth, and we grow the embryo in the laboratory for 3 to 5 days. So at the same time, we would prepare the lady's uterus or the place where the embryo has to implant. The lining of the uterus is prepared with the help of hormonal medication in order to receive that embryo. So once the uterus is ready and the embryo is ready, we call back the couple to the clinic, take the lady to the embryology OT again, to the lab again, and with the help of a very soft catheter or a tube, we place the embryo inside the uterine cavity in the on the endometrial lining. So once the embryo gets implanted, pregnancy will happen. So after placing the embryo, the lady can go home immediately, and there will be a list of a set of instructions, a set of medication and certain precautions that the couple has to follow. So about 2 weeks time from the day the embryo transfer has been performed, we do blood test which tells us whether a pregnancy has happened. So this is exactly how IVF cycle works.